Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTV UK. Welcome back to the channel and another PMT behind the scenes vlog. And I've got some cool stuff to show you in this week's vlog. The most important thing, as you can probably see from the title and the thumbnail, is the fact that I'm going to unbox one of my favourite guitars. It's a 1959 VOS Les Paul Standard from the Gibson Custom Shop. It's going to be immense. I can already smell the amazing nitrocellulose from here. And I can smell the guitar through this. The nitrocellulose smells like vanilla candy. It's so good. Stop talking, Dagan, and open it. Let's just take it all in. Look at that flame maple top. We're going to check out a couple of cool things in the Newcastle studio room that will be going live at PMTV UK, or will be live right now. Like this ridiculous thing. Look at that! And why is it so awesome? This thing looks like it was designed in the 60s, thinking this is what basses would look like in 2021. Also, we've just had some Yamaha guitars land, electric and acoustic. And a few weeks ago I did a an awesome fact video that you probably didn't know about Yamaha guitars, about the history and some cool things about the brand. I'll link it in the description box down below. And you guys seem to really like it, so this has just landed and I thought I'd talk you through this amazing Yamaha FG800. A very affordable, awesome acoustic dreadnought guitar. And it also shows off the fact that I record these vlogs using my iPhone, and I record the audio using the Shure MV88 Plus, a little studio condenser mic for my iPhone, which is sat on top right now. And how good does that sound recording a video with that little microphone with an acoustic guitar? Also have a little wander downstairs here at PMT Newcastle and see what's tasty on the walls. I know there's been some cool guitars land, some cool pedals land, so we'll have a little gander and maybe chat to the lads down there and see which is their favourite. Right, let's talk about this. This is a totally inexpensive Yamaha guitar and it sounds, looks, plays and feels awesome. At the minute, the time of recording this video, middle of June 2021, this guitar is around about 250 quid. Which is not a lot of money for the specs and the feel. It is a lot of money to some, 250 quid is still a lot of money, but when you pick it up and play it, you realise that there's a lot of bang for your buck here. Solid spruce top. First off, it's a dreadnought shape. Sorry, before I start talking about the tone woods. And I always think dreadnoughts are like a Swiss Army guitar shape. It's the most common guitar body shape, but it's the most common because it does strumming stuff really well, it does intricate picking stuff really well, and everything in between. So those tone woods. Solid spruce top. Yep, solid spruce top for under 300 quid, it's crackers, and a NATO back and sides and the bound as well. So there's 3-ply binding, so it looks really nice. And the wood itself, NATO, is, it's got the same tonal properties-ish as mahogany, it's just a bit more not reliable. We've cut down less mahogany trees and now we have to start using NATO, but the tone is pretty much the same. A lovely satin NATO neck as well, again that kind of mahogany. And it's all matte. This is a beautiful matte finished guitar. You can't get it in other colours, but this is the rustic one, especially set off beautifully with a tortoiseshell pickguard. A bit closer now, I might be able to see the binding a bit better. It's a walnut fingerboard as well, 20 frets. It's bound all the way up the fingerboard. It's just aesthetically a really nice guitar. There is no strap button thing here, so you've got to Johnny Cash it. Or Elvis Presley it and have it low slung. But yeah, it sounds awesome. Points if you can name this song down below in the comments. Chorus. So it does everything really well. It's got a beautiful balanced tone, which is well known in dreadnought shaped guitars. And the fact it's got a solid spruce top for the price point is just awesome. And because you're watching the vlog, I'm gonna give you a little sneaky secret. If you're in a PMT store and you wanna walk away with a Yamaha guitar, a Yamaha acoustic guitar, ask them if they can do you a lovely deal on some gig bags, and I'm sure they can sort you out with some tasty Yamaha gig bags. I've got one here. Even they sorted me out. Check that out. So it's a lovely Pally gig bag with nice red binding, and you always know what kind of guitar you've got. A fun little fact from that fact video. This is the Yamaha logo. Everyone knows it. You'll see it on a golf cart. You'll see it on a DVD player. You'll see it on a Yamaha R1 superbike. And they always hark back to their music heritage, because they started as a musical instrument company before they started making motorbikes and jet skis. But that logo is three tuning forks. A really, really cool thing. And if you want to know other fun Yamaha facts, like I say, click the link in the description box down below. But let's go for a wander. I don't know why I wandered off like that. I'm not wandering very far for now. Let's start by having a gander at this Vox Starstream bass. I'm going to have a little fiddle with that in a second and talk you quickly through the specs, but if you want to see a full video review on this, click the link in the description box down below. It's just awesome. And this is the box. I've already sealed it. I've already broke the seal, as it were, because I was going to look at it, but I was like, no, I want to put this in the vlog. Gibson Custom Shop 59 VOS. It's absolutely awesome. Right, let's go for a wander. Because everyone's now gigging again, now the country's starting to sort itself out after COVID, we've just had some epic, I don't know much about high-tech stuff or live sound stuff, but I know what sounds good, and I've heard these a lot over the past couple of days. The new HH PA systems, they aren't a lot of money. They're reliable, they're loud, they're clear, they're beautiful, and PMT now have lots of HH speakers for your live band. If you're starting out, if you're an entire rock band, if you're a singer-songwriter, acoustic dude or dudette, check out HH speakers, they're awesome. Tell you what sounds good through a HH speaker system, a Kemper Profiler. Now this is very cool, loads of Kempers have just landed here at PMT, the power heads, the regular heads, the ones with the floorboards, the Kemper Stage. Let me know what you think of Kempers down below in the comments. I was gonna buy one, but I ended up going for a Helix after I sold my Axe FX. They all sound great, they all just sound slightly different. One necessarily not better than the other, just lots of different variations of doing the same thing. Let me know what you think of Kempers, I think they're awesome. There's been some very nice guitars land here at PMT. You can't beat a Gretsch wall. This is the smaller Gretsches, all the bigger Gretsches are down there. So you've got the Streamliners at the back, all the double jet stuff, that gorgeous thing, Electromatic, the G5665, I think? So cool. And the new Les Paul Studios. They're up the game for the studios. That's the entry-level Gibson Les Paul. I think that's like a whiskey burst at the front and an ebony one behind it. So cool. That's the space for the 59 I'm going to unbox in a second. And that is a Custom Shop 57. That's badass. He likes that. I love this thing. One of my favourite guitars. Obviously my love for Kramer is well known, but the old Sambora model, which kind of took on a life of its own when Kramer went away for a bit and Sambora started using other things. There's a video of this coming very soon. I couldn't not play that. And all the pointy guitars. The Prophecies. What have I shipped over? Crush 20RT. All the Prophecies, the Xtura, Futura and Explorer Mara, Hybrid, Fishman pickups, Ebony fingerboard, and what's cool about the inlays, they've all got the Custom Shop appointments as well on the headstocks. What's cool about the inlays is they've got little Vs, abalone Vs cut out with a mother of pearl, and that corresponds to whatever colour is on the SG, the Flying V or the Xtura. Got the blue ones and the red ones and the rest. These are some of the most amazing modern guitars you've ever played. You've got to rock up to a PMT store and try one of these out. We've had another Jarrah James Nichols Stackland. These things sell like hotcakes because one, they look great, and two, they sound awesome too. Based off the HT20, but with Jarrah's little flair, there's two mismatched speakers in the bottom as well, so it sounds different to any other Blackstar cab. Forgot that Mano, I've got one of these in my living room and I use it all the time. Not just because it matches my curtains, but because it sounds awesome and delivers all the tones you want. Speaking of fun colours, check out that. That's a new Talman acoustic guitar from Ibanez, and I think we've got a pink one as well. So the Talman acoustics have been out for a number of years now, but they've had a bit of a revamp. Check out that new revamped Talman logo. And they're gorgeous. They're not a lot of money, they're electric. And they kind of feel like an electric guitar. So for the folk out there who aren't really acoustic players or think they're a bit too big to play acoustic, think the guitars themselves are a bit too big to play, try an Ibanez Talman out and it'll feel more like you're playing a lovely electric guitar. Got a bit of a bet on here. Does the, will the postman get his van in there in between that Range Rover and that SUV? What do you reckon?
He's He's gonna crash. Right, let's not film it then. So these Talmans are awesome. They also come in a really cool color, which I was looking at before. So Galaxy Black, open pore. So it's a bit more expensive than 199, but you get that glorious kind of open pore finish. He's bottled it, the hazards are on, he's just staying there. Right, let's go upstairs.
Now before we get to the piece de resistance of this video, unboxing that custom shop, I just want to show you this. Everyone thought this was a bit daft when it landed here at PMC Newcastle, but as soon as you play it, you realise that this has been designed, well, they say it's been designed, to be the comfiest, most well-balanced bass, and they do guitar versions, in the world. So this is a Vox Star Stream, and there's a full review at PMTV UK where you're watching this right now. Poplar centre with gorgeous moulded ABS plastic wings, which makes it feel like you're playing a full-size bass, and it's super comfy under your forearm. You can get at the dusty end, no problem. Two single coils in this variant. There's also a version with one big humbucker, a volume for each pickup, and a master tone control. Lovely maple neck, 21 frets, proper retro headstock. This thing looks like it was designed in the 60s, thinking this is what basses would look like in 2021. That's the vibe I'm going for, and it's awesome. Both pickups together then. Just the neck pickup. It's got the nicest tone is the neck pickup in this bass. I think it's absolutely lovely. What bass lines to play. When you pick up a bass, you're like, oh, all these bass lines in my head are just now gone. But no matter what you play on this bass, it sounds fantastic. It's got some hair when you want it, it's lovely and soft when you need it. It's just awesome. Check out the Vox Starstream bass. I said they also do guitar variants, and this one has the two single coils. It's linked down below. Right, let's open a Gibson. Who's ready for this? This is what it's like when you, or in this case me, gets a brand new Gibson Custom Shop guitar. This is the experience of opening what is a £5,000 guitar. Right, here we go. Actually, I'm gonna pop you on a stand because I don't want to drop anything. Welcome back. Right, here we go. Can you tell I'm excited? Lots of cardboard, excess cardboard. I always keep my Gibson boxes as well because I think they, one, make great boxes for shipping stuff in, and they just look cool in your garage and stuff. Also, the Custom Shop Gibson boxes have the Custom Shop logo on, where the regular ones just have the regular headstock. That's a fun little Gibson Easter egg right there. Only the finest bubble wrap. Brown case of glory. One-handed, a £5,000 guitar.
So the Gibson case has the Gibson logo. It's this beautiful brown. The Custom Shop cases are different to your regular run-of-the-mill brown Gibson cases. They're just a bit fancier. And I can smell the guitar through this. The nitrocellulose smells like vanilla candy. It's so good. Stop talking, Dagan, and open it. I was ready for this. So, there's no ketchup on the top, which there usually is on Les Pauls, just all down the bottom here. Four little kind of ones that just pull away, and there's one regular latch. Right in the middle here. Oh my god. Right, off the bat, you have a little poker chip protector thing, like a little macaroon protecting the switch. Look at her. Holy crap. So this is a 1959 VOS Les Paul Standard. VOS means vintage original spec, so everything on this guitar is as like it was when it was new in 1959. For the eagle-eyed, the switch tip doesn't actually come on the guitar from the factory. It comes in the little pocket, which I'll show you now. Let's just take it all in. Look at that flame maple top. It's so bloody active, as you'd expect, because this is the creme de la creme. If you don't want to go Murphy Lab or something over Les Pauls. So I'll talk you through some specs in a second. There's going to be a full in-depth video of this guitar going live at PMTV UK. I can't wait to watch that. I can't wait to film that, let alone watch it afterwards. Looking at the case itself, it's got the beautiful pink kind of velvety loveliness inside. There's a cool little insert here for the headstock, for that angled headstock to stop it snapping in transit, or to help it stop snapping. And the pocket here, you got the beautiful leather-bound certificate of authenticity inside. So cool, as well as other little cool bits of case candy. All the gear they use, only the best Switchcraft looks, and it's got paper and all capacitors. So cool. All the little glorious goodies, the final checklist and the warranty. That, I don't know what that is, that's the case of the case. There's the switch tip down here, and this is a spare, or replacement, sorry, cover for the back of the switch, because from the factory it's got the custom shop Gibson cover on the back. So let's take a closer look at this guitar. So it's VOS, it's not perfectly brand new, it's made to look aged-ish, not relic, just a bit aged, as you can see by the covers and some of the nickel hardware down there. Full mahogany construction, so mahogany neck, mahogany body. The neck is glued in with hide glue, very period correct, and there's no weight relief on the body. It's one single piece of very light mahogany, no weight relief. And that glorious flame maple top. Look at that. This is an iced tea burst, probably one of my favorite finishes, kind of halfway between cherry and a total amber finish. It's the little things that get me. Like, look at those really high pickup surrounds compared to a regular pickup surround. It's just so period correct, and the more white around the outside truss rod cover on that beautiful Gibson headstock. Indian Rosewood fingerboard, a 12-inch radius, and the pickups are custom bookers. So you can't buy these off the shelf. These are made only for the custom shop 59s, Alnico 3 magnets. I've seen people sell these on eBay, like, out of a guitar for like 700 quid. Absolute madness. Would you leave the pickguard cover on, or take it off? Because that top's really nice, but it's more period correct, isn't it, with it on? Thumb bleeder pointers down there, and like I said before, paper in oil capacitors for the tone. That's enough chat, let's hear it. Joy to play. I've had the pleasure of playing a few of these 59 VOS guitars, and they're just unbelievable. The time and effort that goes into these guitars is tenfold over the Les Paul standards, the regular ones. So from the wood choice to the pickups and everything in between, there's no wonder they cost this much. And it is a lot of money, but it's cheaper than an actual 59. It resonates for days as well. It's got, well, it is the Spinal Tap guitar. It's the Spinal Tap. Listen to the sustain. Ah! It's that guitar. So the sustain. It's just there. And the first thing you notice is the pots are really good. So from 1 to 10, it makes a drastic difference where you are. So 1 sounds different to 2. 3 sounds different to 7. Obviously, it's not just a volume. It reacts differently, and the whole thing kind of...
take in this guitar. When you're playing it, you're not really caring about the notes you play or how you're standing. You're just kind of embracing the whole thing. And I'm aware of what I was saying before of how good the pots are and stuff, and you could buy these pots and this capacitors for your guitar and it'll be awesome, but it's the recipe of everything what makes this guitar something special. And now I'm a salesperson and I work in a guitar store, so I'm obviously going to say it's mint, but literally play one. We will let you play one. If you rock up to a PMT store, we will let you play the 59, because just say Dagan said you could. The chords. Right, I'm not going to play anymore. I'm going to wait until the full review goes live at PMT UK on YouTube for you to hear more of a mic'd up amplifier and some more spec sights and sounds on the amazing 1959 VOS Les Paul Standard from the Gibson Custom Shop in Ice Tea Burst. It's absolutely awesome. And again, I know I work in a guitar store and I'm trying to sell stuff like you do when you work in guitar stores, but there's a reason these are sought after by so many players out there, and there's a reason guitar players who have 59 Les Pauls play the copies on the road. It's as close as you can get, and it's a really special thing to play as a guitar player. And that's it, ladies and gents, for this week's PMT behind the scenes vlog. Thank you for joining me. Comment down below your favorite bit. I know I've asked you to comment quite a bit, but everyone's busy and I've got no one to talk to, so comment down below what you think of this guitar, the Raj Vox thing. You can get some tasty free gig bags if you chat to the staff at PMT about Yamaha acoustics. And yeah, that's all for this week. Let me know also what you want to see in these vlogs in the future. More lessons, more tone tips, some more beautiful guitar porn. Just let me know what you want to see and I will try and deliver with myself and the rest of the beautiful PMT crew. I've been Dagan. That's been a Shure MV88 Plus, getting all this audio in. That's a Black Star, and I'll see you next time.